In this problem, step number one. Step number two, test for exact. You can see that both are exact. Step number three, integrate this with respect to x and also integrate this with respect to y, both partially. If I integrate this partially with respect to x, then I will be partial against y and integrate just cos x, and I'm going to have sin x. If I integrate sin x, I will have minus cos s. The minus will multiply this minus and you have a plus. And because we are partial against y, is going to be a constant, which is a function of y. Similarly, if I integrate this partially respecting just y, to integrate just this, I'm going to have y square. I'm going to ignore sin x and be partial against x. If I integrate 2, I will just give it a y because I'm respecting the y. Hence, our constant will be a function that is constant but a function of x. The partial integration of m with respect to x becomes my answer, which is this. However, I will now compare to replace h of y. Next, which is step number four, compare. What are you comparing? The both integrated functions. These on both sides are the same, so they will cancel out. Hence, what is remaining is h of y is going to be equal on the other side, and g of x will be equal to cos x on the other side. However, I'm after h of y and not g of x. Next, I will substitute for my h of y, which is 2y, is equal to a constant. This becomes my answer and my final result. In the next video, you will learn integrating factor method of solving ordinary differential equation. I will see you in the next video.